tragically has become a national symbol of corporate irresponsibility. Industrial producers and users of chemicals have too often disposed of highly toxic materials with the utter disregard for the danger which these materials pose to the environment and to future generations.
Love Canal is named after Mr. William T. Love. Mr. Love was an entrepreneur, and what he wanted to do was connect the upper and lower Niagara River through this canal. What he essentially wanted to do was move the mighty Niagara Falls, as we call it locally, onto his property. And in doing so, he could harness the dropping of water and be a zillionaire, because he would have this huge energy that he could sell to everybody. Unfortunately, he had part of the canal dug at both ends, and then money fell away, the depression set in, and he never completed his project. I saw the hospital,
and the shoreline like a By 1920, the land was sold and was transformed into a chemical dumping site until 1953. Hooker Chemical Corporation subsidiary, Occidental Petroleum, was the main dumper of the chemicals at the site. Niagara City, as well as the U.S. Army, also used the canal as a dumping site. Parts of the Manhattan Project, a project to construct a nuclear bomb during World War II, were disposed there also. Thousands of chemicals roamed the canal, unknowing of the future homeowners in the surrounding community. Hooker Chemical Corporation filled the canal in 1953. They sold the land to the Board of Education for $1. Construction began on houses around the canal in the 1950s without warning or information that their homes would be located just blocks from a toxic waste
and
dump.
And I did not know about Love Canal. Nobody told me when I bought that ideal home in the ideal community that there was 20,000 tons of chemicals underneath the school that my son would eventually be attending.
In 1978, 800 private single-family homes and 240 apartments had been built around the canal. The elementary school was at the center of the landfill. The choice was mine, I didn't think enough. I'm too depressed. Since the homes were built, people continuously complained of mysterious odors and substances appearing in their yards and at the playground at the 99th Street Elementary School. The substances were merely covered with clay. The frequency of the complaints demanded an investigation. The county was forced to conduct a study. Toxic chemical was found in the air, and toxic residue was found in homes near the south end of the canal. Nothing was done by the city, and the health of Love Canal's residents quickly went downhill. Students attending the 99th Street School soon developed similar illnesses. Mothers near the Love Canal became suspicious, especially a woman named Lois Gibbs.
And after living there for a while, Michael got really sick. Michael was healthy when he moved in. He developed liver problems, urinary tract disorder, which required two operations to correct. He developed asthma, epilepsy. The city government was not moving. The county government shut the door in my face. The state government shut the door in my face. And obviously the school board, Dr. Long, who was the superintendent of schools at the time, slammed the door in my face. And so I did a petition and went door to door and said, look, you know, do you have problems with your kids? I think it's related to the school. 56% of our children were born with birth defects. Three ears, double rows of teeth, extra fingers, extra toes, or mentally retarded. There were these three women who lived side by side, not genetically related in any way. All three of them had children born with the exact same birth defect, which was the children didn't have a hole in the top of their skull when they were born. So their skulls can't grow, and obviously their brains can't grow. They could correct it with surgery, but it was just, you know, those kind of stories when I went door to door. There were 22 women who were pregnant at the time of the study, and only four babies were born normally. The other pregnancies ended in miscarriages, stillborn babies, or birth defective children. We had a 21-year-old who died of crib death. I don't think so. I mean, some of this stuff was just, we had a young girl who was 12 years old who had a hysterectomy due to cancer. I mean, it was just bizarre when you heard the stories. Get up, stand up,
up for your right.
The Love Canal Homeowners Association consisted of about 500 families within a 10-block radius. The community would stop at nothing to understand what was happening not only to their lives, but to their children's lives as well. A task force was put into place in 1974. The task force was started to relocate families and board up homes, but unfortunately, it could not accommodate everyone. The government had finally responded, but the challenge was keeping it involved enough to do something.
February 8, 1979. More bad news from the State Health Department. New Commissioner David Axelrod recommends the temporary relocation of all pregnant women and children under two who live within a 6-block perimeter. On December 20, 1979, the U.S. Justice Department files a $117 million lawsuit against Hooker Chemicals. On April 28, 1980, the state of New York files a $635 million lawsuit against the company. May 16, 1980, a study released by the Environmental Protection Agency shows rare chromosomal damage among some Love Canal residents. Apparently, the last straw. A few days later, two EPA officials are taken hostage by the residents. They were let go only to wait for 2 days to hear if President Carter would announce a federal emergency. That announcement came with an offer of temporary relocation. 3 more months would pass before permanent relocation would be possible.
And now will you see the light? Just stand up for your rights. Yeah.
In 1983, the homeowners succeeded. The lawsuit was settled. They received compensation, but the money would never make up for the deaths, the sickness, and the horror inflicted on the community. Occidental Petroleum and the U.S. government made an agreement, and Occidental was responsible for the chemical cleanup, costing over $197 million.
We, the people, have been very patient in our efforts to obtain.
We know our house is contaminated.
After all, we know our health has been affected.
I would like to say that we have faced many problems.
We did nothing wrong.
Some of us have been sick.
I'm a wife,
yet none of my mothers are married. I live in the Congress and Congress of
America.
The government has passed a sense of government.
I also love financiality.
For
I don't want to
have any people
to come
to
test it.
To choose life, but no authorities or agencies
as callously as a strange life that I lead now.
The actions and
it is filled with disruptions and frustration
that leads to prevent what has happened at Love Canal from ever happening again.
This is a warning, and it's going to catch you. You better wake up now.
Where are you? And I'm so sorry. I cannot sleep, I cannot dream tonight. I need somebody and always. This sick, strange darkness comes creeping on, so haunting every time. And as I stared, I counted webs from all the spiders, catching things and eating their insides. Like indecision to call you and hear your voice of treason. Will you come home and stop this pain tonight? Stop this pain tonight. Don't waste your time on me.